All right, guys, as you can see, it's sundown here, and we're heading out for walleyes tonight. We're heading out of Sturgeon Bay, Wisconsin. The night bite's been real good. We're going to hit it tonight pretty hard and see if we can't put a couple big fish in the boat. This type of fishing is really unique. If you haven't done it, it's something you should definitely try. We're going to give you some tips and techniques tonight, hopefully show you a few of these big Door County walleyes. You'll be able to do this yourself. What we're going to do is we're going to troll mainly. Troll big stick baits, troll crank baits. It's going to be a shallow water bite. We're trolling the edges of these shorelines for these big pre-spawn and close to spawning type fish. So stay tuned. It's going to be another great show, and we'll see you in a little bit. All right, so we got our first fish of the night on here, guys. Hit a deep husky jerk on the outside set, which is typical this time of the year. We're just at dark now, and a lot of times our first bites will come on the outside boards. And as the night progresses, we'll start to see a shift to some of our hand lines and flat lines being hit, and then the inside baits as the fish move shallower. But this seems like a nice fish here. Got some weight this time of the year. I mean, up in these waters, you never know, it could be a really big fish. So we'll get this fish in and, you know, see what we got. Okay, so we got the board off, guys. We only got about 20 feet here left. Should be seeing this fish pretty soon. And it feels like a nice fish. I mean, it's not a giant, but it's a great way to start the night here. And the typical fish that you can expect up here in Door County. Let's see what we got here. There we go. That's a beautiful Door County walleye right there, guys. And that's what we come out after dark for. Not the biggest fish you're gonna see, but just a beautiful fish. And there's a beautiful fish. I mean, that's what we come up here to fish for. That's why we stay up late at night. That's why we do what we do out here. This is just a beautiful fish. Not a giant. I mean, we're gonna see bigger fish tonight, hopefully, than this. But I'll tell you what, when this is your average size fish, you're not gonna find a better bite. I mean, gotta get out and try this. We're gonna show you guys how to do this. And you can come up here and catch somebody on your own. Let this big fish go here. Better get a little bigger. Try to catch her again next year.
Boy, I'll tell you what. You know, something really strange this time of the year. You know, we're trolling pretty slow, you know, less than 2 miles an hour. And, you know, we got baits kind of scattered throughout the water column. We got some shallow, we got some a little bit deeper in our hand lines. I particularly, I'm running mine pretty close to the bottom. And what I'm doing is just constantly sweeping my rod. And it's kind of funny, I'm letting the bait out a little farther. All of a sudden, the line just kept taking off. And I'll tell you what, I can't move this fish. This is a big fish. It really is. This could be the one we're really looking for this time of the year. Oh yeah, she's a dandy. I could just see her. This is why we walleye fish, guys. This is why we walleye fish. That is what we come for. Look at the size of that fish.
That's an absolute beauty, right? right here. This is what makes Door County famous, right here.
And that's why we put these hours in. We come out after dark, and this is kind of what the reward is. I'll tell you what, Mike, that is what we come out here for. Look at this fish. And here's the amazing thing about this fish. This is a spawned out female. 44 degree water, 43 degree water. You know, sometimes, you know, everybody thinks these fish do the same thing at the same time. You know, when they spawn, they all spawn. Definitely not true. You got some early spawners, you definitely got some late spawners. And, you know, this one just happens to be spawned out, but what a beauty. This is why we spend the time coming out here at night, putting the time in to catch these fish. Definitely a trophy. This is why we come out here at night, folks. Catch fish like this.
You know, guys, we've talked a lot tonight about flat lines, or hand lines as we often refer to them as. And basically, it's a real simple setup. It's a rod, inner rod holder, flat line straight behind the boat. Only things that we do different to it when we troll at night for these big walleyes is we keep the rod in our hand. And basically, the one reason we do that is so we can, you know, put a little action onto the bait, a little more than it would just be normally pulled behind the boat. The technique is very simple. We're holding the rod here, we're pulling it a foot to 2 feet forward, slowly, and then just letting it settle back. We want to keep a tight line at all times. We don't want it to free fall back. Pull it forward a foot or two, let it go back. I would say 80% of the bites that we get on this setup is when the rod is falling back. These fish instinctively are following baits. It's an instinct to grab something that falls back towards them. When you look at equipment for that, we like to use Shimano combos here. A nice Shimano line counter, reel, and rod is a perfect setup for this type of technique. The nice thing about the line counters is that it lets you duplicate the set. Get yourself a nice long rod so you can apply a little action to it, control the fish a little better, and I'll tell you what, you're gonna put a lot of fish in the boat this spring.
Can you believe that? I put the rod in the rod holder, and right away, we get a bite. I'll tell you what, it's just a crazy, crazy night tonight. Oh, there she is. Ooh, this is a nice fish. Wow. Barely hooked.
Dog. Get him. That's stuck.
Okay. Oh, man. Look at this fish. Oh, my God. Look at this fish. Look at the head on this fish. I mean, our last fish was almost identical, bigger. But just, you know, the last two fish, you know, pushing over 9 pounds. Just an unbelievable night. Mike, that board.
Well, I'll tell you what, Tim. I mean, this is crazy tonight. I mean, we didn't even barely get your big fish out of the net. We look over and the inside board has popped off right away. So, I mean, this is what can happen up here this time of the year, though. I mean, when you get on these fish, the conditions are right, and your baits are set properly, you can put some big fish in the boat and some numbers as well. Don't just think this is a big fish bite this time of the year, because when you get on them and you're set right, you can put numbers in the boat along with size. So this is the type of stuff that makes Door County so special this time of the year. There's not many other places anywhere you'll go where you can pull these kind of numbers and this kind of size of the fish that we've been catching tonight. I mean, it's truly special.
You know, Mike, our last two fish approaching, 29, 30 inches, somewhere in that range. The last two fish, I mean,
yeah.
That's unbelievable.
It's just crazy. I mean, in the amount of bites we're getting, I mean, usually you have a trade-off. You have one or the other. You get a lot of action, but usually they're smaller, or you might luck into a big fish if you put your time in. This is incredible. I mean, we're talking huge numbers and big fish as well. So let's get this one in and see what we got here.
Wow, another big fish.
Boy, and I'll tell you what, I mean, you know, this is a special fishery.
Oh, look at the size of that fish.
All right, guys, this is what it's all about right here. Oh, guys, I mean, you know this is a special fishery. when this is the type of fish you're getting doubled on. I mean, this is the smaller of the two. When this is the smaller of the two doubles, I mean, it's incredible. I mean, this is what makes Door County special. This is what makes this type of time of the year so important to the fishery. I mean, get up here, take advantage of this fishery while it's going on right now, and I'm telling you what, you can put fish like this in the boat yourselves. Let's let this guy go and let him get even a little bigger.
Well, here we go again. You know, when you get on these trolling passes, you know, really being key and very specific to your pass that you're making. You know, we're contour trolling some steep drops on these shores here. And, you know, some people will say that, well, you get to this time of the night, you don't need to run boards. But, you know, we like running boards because boards catch a lot of extra fish.
A little further, Timmy. I'll tell you what.
Oh my God. Look at this fish. I'm telling you what, this is what happens when you put the time in. You know, we're catching a lot of nice fish here tonight and putting the time in, and boy, you wind up catching one like this. This is a fish of a lifetime here. You know, this fish is probably well over 10 pounds, probably 30 inches or maybe a little bit better. And that's the kind of fish that you can catch out here. You do some of the techniques and some of the tactics that we're talking about, fishing those hand lines, fishing those boards, covering those contours, and you can catch a fish just like this. Let this thing go so someone else can catch it.
Boy, you know, the bites just keep coming tonight. We got another one on here now. We were just trying to reset lines after the last fish where we had a clear, and just this board didn't get 20 feet outside the boat, and we had another one on. So another nice fish, and I'll tell you what, when you get on these fish right and the conditions are right, you're gonna put a pile of them in the boat. Well, we're working this fish in, guys. Here, we got the board off now, and I'll tell you what, this is a big fish. And this is what you come out here for, like we've said all night. This is why you lose sleep. This is why you get back in the morning, sometimes at 2, 3 in the morning. But I'll tell you what, when you get a big bite like this and you feel these big head shakes, if you're a walleye fisherman, this is what it's all about right here.
Yeah. Oh, man!
This is what we come out at night for.
But that is a horse. That is a trophy.
Just what we said. That's why we come out, spend the time we do at night. That's all about right there. I'll tell you what. I mean, that's the type of fish right there that made Door County famous. I mean, that is an absolute beast of a walleye. And I'll tell you what, I mean, that's what's so cool about this time of the year. I mean, you can get these things. Maybe not this big on a regular basis, but you can get big, quality-sized walleyes all through the month of April out here. And I'll tell you what, if you're a walleye fisherman, that's what you come out for every spring. Just a beautiful Door County walleye. So guys, if you get a chance, take a few days, get up here during the month of April, put into use some of the stuff that we talked about and showed you tonight, and you can catch a fish of a lifetime like this too. Thanks for watching, and join us next week for an all-new episode of Fish Door County TV.